Hi, this is Sean. In this video, I'm going to go over light baking. So what is light baking? Well, over the last several years, it's become an expectation to use an advanced lighting solution for most of your renderings that can take a long time to compute. And so a lot of people I've seen rendering out AO passes or global illumination for every single frame of their animation. And sometimes objects in the foreground or background don't have major lighting shifts, and they are wasting a lot of render time computing all that extra advanced lighting solution for every single frame. And so what you could do is you could bake in a lighting solution into your texture maps. And so how do you do that? Well, the first step is usually to specify a UV set for your light maps. And especially if you're going to go out to a video game engine, you can go under the create UVs, and there's the UV set editor. And so you can see on all of my objects, I've created light set one here. If we look at the UV set editor, for the light map set, you definitely want to have non-overlapping UVs. So for the base set here, if I wanted to use, I made a quick texture that used cylindrical mapping. And so, you know, you can have overlapping shells for your diffuse channel. But when it comes to the AO pass, you want to have your own separate channel and you want to at least do an auto mapping. But you can even improve it from there if you take the time. So how do you actually run the texture baking? You need to go into the rendering menu. So F6 on your keyboard to jump to the rendering menu. And then under lighting and shading, if you look under assign new bake sets, I did a texture bake set. And then within that menu, the default is under, it's like lighting and color, but I chose occlusion, but you could also try out global illumination. The occlusion rays are default to 64, but you can turn this up to get a little bit more advanced of a solution, of a calculation. And the higher number, higher you turn this up, you'll sort of reduce some of the graininess. But I'll mention in a second how you can take care of some of that graininess if it bothers you in Photoshop, in post, after you do a calculation. You want to give it a name, and the texture resolution, you know, quite often 1K or 2K map is sort of standard in terms of resolution right now, although it's been going up every year. Finally, when you run this calculation, quite often you will get some artifacting along the edges of your UV seams. And one of this option, fill texture seams, I think it's default to 1, but you can turn it up to 2 or higher. And here there's no texture seams. And here I used a different lighting solution initially, and I still have some seams, so I could recalculate and turn that up like right in here. Before, when I tried an initial pass, I got a ton of seams. I forgot to turn that option on. All right, so once this is calculated, it will create a material and it will drop the AO pass into the incandescence channel. And so quite often you've got a lot of grain, and or you might want to like tweak your AO pass baked light map in Photoshop. You could apply additional blurs or increase the contrast to get your light map baked the way you want it. Maybe you want your AO to be closer to the object and less diffused around it. In addition, there's one more setting that you can try out within the baked set. If you want to, you can change the occlusion fall off to a higher number, and that sometimes can reduce the fall off or the ambient occlusion around your object and make it tighter by default. So finally, let's go over how you might be able to use these maps in combination with a texture. So what I did was I created a quick texture And within that texture, I created it was just a standard blend. And in the color channel, I created a layered texture. And in that layered texture, I have my color channel, which is just a procedural cloth, and then I've multiplied it with my AO map. So you can see right here, if I apply this, and I've got a bump and a little bit of glow on here. And so let's just go and let me show you some of the renders I did. Here's the image rendered with the AO pass. Here's the image rendered without the AO pass multiplied in. So you can see the AO gives it a nice little bit of extra advanced lighting feeling. Finally, as you have computed all of your ambient occlusion and baked it into your light solution, now you can turn off mental ray and render out with Maya software, or turn off all of your settings in mental ray, and you'll get a much accelerated rendering output. So that's pretty much what I wanted to cover, and thanks so much for watching.